In our previous lesson, we wrote and executed our first C program. We printed hello world on screen. We used GCC compiler, which runs from command line, to compile our program. Now, in this lesson, we will see how we can use compilers that we call integrated development environments or IDEs to write, compile, and execute our program. IDEs give you a rich editor, a nice user interface, and a bunch of features that help you manage big projects and detect errors in your program. Some of the IDEs that you can use for C are Dev-cpp, this is a light one. There is another one named Code Blocks. Visual Studio Express Edition, this one is by Microsoft, and this is what I will use in most of the lessons in this series. There is another one named Eclipse for C, C++. Typically, an IDE would support both C and C++. IDE or compiler, you can use these terms for each other. That's what we do practically. There is one more thing that I want to point out. It's good if your compiler follows the latest standards for C language. There are some compilers that are too outdated, like Turbo C. I would not recommend using Turbo C. You can use any among the rest. I will come back to showing how we can use some of these IDEs. But first, I'll open the program that we had written in our previous lesson. A compiler takes a C source file. A compiler for C will take a C source file and create an executable file. If there is a syntactical error in your program, compilation fails. Compiler gives you error messages that we call compilation errors. Compilation errors should help you fix your program. For example, it's a rule that every statement in C must end with a semicolon. Let's remove this semicolon from here. And now let's compile this file using GCC. To compile, we would give GCC space the C source file name. Now, as you can see, I'm getting some error message here. It's saying that in function int main at line 6, a semicolon is expected. If I would fix this error, put a semicolon at the end of this printf statement, save the file, and then compile again, there is no error. If there would be a compilation error, no fresh executable file will be created. If compilation passes, an executable file named a.exe will be created afresh. You can run this executable file from command line. If you would like to give your executable file a name of your choice in GCC while using GCC, what you can do is you can type in GCC C source file name space minus O, and then you type in the name that you want for executable. For example, let's say I want helloworld.exe, then I'll just say hello world. With this, an executable file named helloworld.exe is created. You can check it from command line also. Type in dir to list all the files in the directory. And now you can run helloworld.exe. Please note that I am on a Windows machine. Things will be pretty similar on a Linux machine. You would not have a file with extension exe. You would have a file with extension out. So you can create something like helloworld.out. Now we will see how we can compile and execute our program in some of these IDEs. We will execute this same program to print hello world. I have opened up Dev-cpp, or what we also call Dev-C++ compiler. I would recommend watching this part of the video in full screen for better clarity. Now the first thing that we need to do is we need to create a C source file. And this time we do not need to use an external editor like Notepad. Go to File in the menu at the top here, then New and click on Source File. You also have a keyboard shortcut for this, and it will open an editor for you in the IDE itself where you can type in your code. I'll write the same program to print Hello World on screen. This time we are getting these nice color codes. As you can see, these keywords int and return are in bold. This first line, which is a library reference, is in some other color. These color codes improve the readability of your program. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to save this source file. To save, either press Ctrl plus S key or go to File and click on Save or Save As. This dialog will open. In this drop down, save as type, select C source file and then give a name for the source file. I'll give name Dev-cpp hello. Once I click on save, my C source file is created. Now I can compile my program. To compile, go to execute in the menu at the top here and click on compile. You also have a keyboard shortcut, Control plus F9 key for this. When you would click on compile, this pop-up will come, and if everything is alright, an executable will be created in the same folder where you would have saved your source file. The name of the executable will be same as the name of the source file. So if my source file is devcpphello.c, my executable is devcpphello.exe. As we had seen earlier, we can double click this executable and try to run the program, but something will flash and go away. The machine will start and finish the execution of program in no time. If you want to see the output, you can run the executable from command line. Go to the folder where the executable is from the command line and type in the name of the executable file. So this way we are able to see the output. The IDE also gives you option to run the program. You can go to execute and click on run. There is a keyboard shortcut, Control plus F10 for this. But this is same as double clicking the executable file. Something will flash and go away quickly. The program will start and finish its execution in no time before you can see the output. To see the output of program by double clicking on the executable or by using this run option in the menu here, we can put a hack in our program. So what I'm going to do here is I'm first going to write a comment in my program. If you would write a line in your program starting with two forward slashes, that line is a comment in your program. It will be ignored by the compiler while compiling. It will not be considered a valid C statement. It will not be considered a C statement to be executed. And now I'll write two C statements. With these two statements, we are saying that the program must take an integer as input from the user. So when you would run the program will wait for you to enter an integer. Let's compile and run this code and see what happens. Compilation is successful and now I can run. As you can see, this console display has come here. Earlier, it would come and go in no time. Now because it's waiting for you to input some integer, it's there and you can see hello world on screen. If I would press any key on the keyboard now and press enter, the console will go away. Some IDEs automatically pause the execution of your program in the end and show you the output. So you do not have to put a hack like this. Dev C++ doesn't do that. And always remember that this is a hack. Different people put different kind of hacks. Some people use a function named getch, which is part of ponio.h library. This function getch will make your program wait until you press some key. But conio.h is not a standard C library. It will not be supported by many compilers, so it is not recommended. If you would have some error in your program, then upon compiling, you would get the error in the IDE. Let's remove this semicolon here and try to compile the program and see what happens. It would be very small for you to see. It's saying that at line 5, where we have a return statement, there is a syntax error before this line. As a newbie, as a beginner in programming, a compilation error would often scare you. It's important that you read the error message carefully and try to see your program and fix the compilation error. If I would put this semicolon here, my program would compile successfully. The error would go away. So Dev-cpp is one of the IDEs that you can use. If you would use other IDEs, things will be almost similar. I have opened up another IDE named Code Blocks. Things are similar here. Go to File, New, and click on Empty File. This time, before writing code, I would first save the file. So I'll press Ctrl S. This dialog will come. Save as type. I'll select it C, C++ files, and then I'll give a name Code Blocks Hello.c. Once I click on save, I can write my program. Now, to compile, I can go to Build in the menu at the top here. And I can click on build. Build and compile, these are synonyms. We use these two terms for each other. If your build is successful, no message will come. you can run the program. You can also use the option build and run. It will do both in one click. So I'll click on build and run. Now code block pauses the console for you to see the output, and once you would press any key, then only the console will exit. As you can see, it's printing some extra messages apart from what you have printed in your code. This definitely is better because we are not having to put the hack. So I have shown you how we can work with two of the IDEs. Things will be almost similar if you would use any other IDE. Some websites, including ours, give you this feature that you can write, compile, and view the output of your program in web browser itself. So you do not have to install anything on your local machine. Links to all of these resources that I'm talking about can be found in the description of this video. From next lesson, we will start getting deeper into C language concepts. This is it for this lesson. Thanks for watching.